Blissed and fire. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night. And you have tuned in to another moment behind the veil with Zaza Zo. Today we're going to get into the topic of the dark side of the entertainment biz. The dark side of the entertainment biz. I am your host, Zaza Zo, and we're going to talk about this little situation between Chrisean, Tamar, and some gay guy who got knocked the fuck out. But first and foremost, let's get things situated before we get into this conversation. We're gonna allow people to slowly come in. I really can't do nothing about it. TikTok is not promoting my lives. I realize there are a lot of features that my page does not have access to. So even though I set up an event for the live, TikTok was not promoting that live. So I have to deal with the algorithm not sharing the information to the group. But we're going to get into this situation in the entertainment biz, because it's a funny situation. Like, how would you feel if someone you invited came to your function, but they came at the wrong time, they entered at the wrong space, and they weren't told all the information regarding your reasoning for being at the event? But we're gonna get into it. But first and foremost, let me get things situated here, because I almost forgot about the live. That's why I don't like setting up times for the lives. I hate setting up time for the lives, because then I'm never on time. But we're going to vibe out real quick so I can get situated, and then we're gonna get into the conversation. Don't forget to like, don't forget to friend, and again, whether you stay or whether you go, thanks for stopping by. Actually, this is the wrong vibration for what we're about to do. Let's see. Okay. I really don't have a favorite song by Tamar, so I'm just going to play one of Tamar's jams. Blissed and Fire, you guys, we're going to talk about this Tamar situation. But let's prepare the vibe. How many people was talking about Tamar's concert before this fiasco with the dark high priestess Chrisean, who's, to be honest with you, Chrisean is a replica of me. She's special needs. She lives her life with an open heart, but she has always these people around her trying to manipulate her and try to suck up her energy. But she's young, and that too is okay. And she's going to learn with these initiations of life who to trust and who not to trust. It's just going to take some time on some old real. You guys, what do you think about this Tamar situation, Tamar, Chrisean, and the gay guy who got his ass knocked the fuck down? What do you think the reasoning was around this? Put your perspective in the comments. And what I notice is that every time I go live and I want to use my other phone for music, my music has never a problem when I'm not live. But as soon as I go live, the problems start flowing with the music and shit. So it is what it is, you guys. We're going to start in a couple of minutes. Don't forget to like, friend, and share. We're going to talk about it. All right, let's get into it. I want to do this within a half an hour, and I'm going to get into the true situation of Chrisean and fucking Tamar. Blissed and fire to all who come into the room. Now let's talk about it. For all of you guys who don't know, my name is Voja. Voja Zazazo. I'm a third generational healer and master alchemist, and I'm also a tarot card reader. So don't forget to subscribe, because all my subscribers, when I start doing readings again, will be open to a free reading with their subscription. So with your subscription, I'm going to be offering subscriber only lives, and in these subscriber only lives, I'm going to do private readings for my subscribers. Our clique is usually really small, which is how I like it. I really don't like a whole bunch of people in my room. A good 10 people in my lives, and I'm good to go. 10 or more. So let's talk about it. Let's get into it. And I'm just going to say my perspective, only because I'm a healer, so I have a different perspective on this whole thing. I truly believe that Night Tamar... But I truly believe that her promoters tried to tactically invite Chrisean. Yes, she has said in the video that she was invited by Tamar. Let me see if I can... Give me 1 second. Let me see if I can find it for you guys. Collections. Yeah, here it is. In one of Tamar's videos, she spoke about how she was invited. Here it is. Let's check it out.
I was by myself. I wasn't with my team. My team was outside waiting. Just waiting till, I don't know, it was time to work, you know? So that's what that happened. All this other false narrative saying this happened, she did that. I don't know what that, I don't know. I think it's just a clout chasing thing, so... Honestly, I have to start protecting my name when I don't know. I don't know how you say Tamar. It was some other, like, the guy that's talking about how he put it together. He didn't put anything together, and I never talked to him. I directly talked to Tamar. She communicated that I could come out, and that was that. I don't know who that guy is, because I never talked to him. He's not gay.
Blissed and fire, you guys. My name is Voja, and we're talking about the Chrisean and Tamar fiasco at Tamar's concert. Did anybody else know that Tamar was on a concert tour? Anyway, this is Chrisean's perspective on the whole situation. This is Chrisean's perspective on the whole situation. She is saying that Tamar invited her. What I'm saying is that her promoters did not invite Tamar at the right time. I mean, not Tamar, did not invite Chrisean at the right time. And I feel because she was introduced on stage at the wrong time, plus she was drunk and all of that, it really made for a huge fiasco at Tamar's event. But let's finish listening to it.
Whatever you like, boys. Him, I don't know how you say, I don't want to be rude, like, because I'm not honest. I don't know what's going on and why popping it, like, I'm not just a female, like, and the clout chasing is kind of, is getting out of hand, so, but nah, it was nothing between me and Tamar. I had nothing to do with any of that, but I don't know, it was just, like, wicked stuff started happening, and then, I don't know, and then I let that go. I went to a party, went back home to my kid, but, like, I had fun. What I don't get is the storytelling. Like, why everybody storytelling? Y'all got all the videos of us cheering, praying. Post the other I'm talking about, because everything is recorded and documented. Yeah, y'all saw how I was on live. I was about...
Okay, so she said she was invited, you guys. She said she was invited to the concert. What you notice if you saw a cup, matter of fact, let me go back. Let's go back. Okay, this is the concert. Let's check it out. It's not alive. Now it doesn't want to show it.
I love you. Come on, sister.
It doesn't want to show it now. You can't see it, you guys. I'm trying to show it to you, but again, I'll say it again. TikTok is a hater. They're not promoting my page. They're not announcing the lives and the features on my TikTok. I have to build a certain amount of following before any of the features work, so it cannot be seen. You should be able to see what I'm trying to show you because it's right in front of the camera, but it's not allowing me to do so. You can see in the video that Tamar is very surprised at the time when Chrisean comes out. And then B, by the time she finished singing, she's surprised that Tamar's on stage at that moment. And you could very much tell when you go look at the video, her pulling Chrisean off of the stage. To me, this was all the promoters' fault. To me, the promoters didn't allow Chrisean to come out at the right time. Two, the lack of communication. I believe Chrisean thought she was coming there to perform, when in all actuality, Tamar just invited her to come and I guess what entertainers call an guest spot and come and show yourself. But to be honest with you, I think this is a publicity stunt gone wrong because there was a situation backstage. Of course, Chrisean got into her feelings because she thought she was supposed to come and perform. Okay, let's get into the mind of Chrisean. You guys need to understand that Chrisean is special like me. There's a lot of us high priestesses that are not of this matrix. So we don't get sly. We don't get, you know, why people abuse in the way they do. We're always in our angelic, childlike mind. So in my head, Chrisean only came there because she was invited by Tamar and she was excited about being invited and she wanted to do what she knew she was good at, which was performing, showing her entertainment. But I don't think she understood that Tamar was just inviting her to come to the event, just to come to the event. She wasn't thinking, oh, I was just invited just to be there, not to sing. So I believe Chrisean was on the stage in her mind. She thought she was going to perform. She thought she was going to sing her song, not connecting that one, Tamar's crowd is not her crowd, to they told her to come on stage at the wrong time in the wrong place. To me, I believe these concert promoters, both of them are gay men individuals because their business wasn't copacetic, wasn't 100. There was confusion with Tamar and there was confusion with Chrisean. Okay? And because of this confusion, it was a big mess. But to be honest with you guys, let's go a little bit deeper. Do you think this was big mess or do you think this was top tier? What's the word I'm looking for? Top tier publicity. Top tier publicity. Because I'll say it again, I didn't even know Tamar was on tour until Chrisean came in the motherfucking building. Okay, and I know, and it's crazy, you guys. You have to consider the characteristics of these two individuals. Tamar is a bougie, rich, ghetto bitch. Okay, Tamar is a bougie itch, whereas Chrisean is a ghetto. I'm sorry to say, she only became bougie because she just started with Zeus, but she was from the streets entertainer itch, okay? So you got two ghetto girls on the stage. One is the well-pampered, well-taken care of, well catered to Tamar. She's a big freaking baby. I don't care what anybody says. Tamar is a big freaking baby. So when she sees this ghetto entertainment rap hood rat, which is Chrisean, to me, I feel like she got in her feelings. Okay, why is this girl on my stage right now when I'm trying to sing the last song? You know what I'm saying? I wanted to pull Chrisean off of the stage because in her bougie rich eyes, which is what her mother created, in her bougie rich eyes, Chrisean was taking the limelight from Tamar. But in all actuality, Tamar, she shined a light, that dark goddess. Because notice in the comment that Chrisean said in the live that she approached this whole situation with, she said, and I quote, "That's when the devils came out." You know, when you're dealing with entertainment people, you're dealing with devils. So the devils coming out is not something you should be surprised about, okay? But I totally saw the jealousy that Chrisean had because, I mean, the jealousy that Tamar had because Chrisean was on stage. And to be honest with you, a lot of gay men can be very rude with their delivery. I don't know what happened between the gay guy and Chrisean. All I know is that he got the lights punched out of him. He must have said something he shouldn't have said to the goddess. Because a lot of gay men, they're quick to speak their truth, but that they speak it in a way that's so ugly that it merits them to get knocked the hell out on some old real shit. So, overstand, I feel they took a beautiful opportunity to have two divas come together on a positive perspective. And if you guys missed any of this live, this will be posted on our YouTube channel. Let me tell you the name of our YouTube channel where we're going to post it at. Hold on. I believe I'm going to post it on the YouTube channel. Zaza Mambo Israel on YouTube. So if you missed any part of this feed, it will be uploaded on YouTube. It will be uploaded on YouTube. I feel like they took a perfect opportunity to bring two independent artists together and actually make it beautiful, but per usual. Matter of fact, I'm going to put it on Zemyaza Healing Core LLC because my YouTube is acting stupid and I can't get the name of my second YouTube station. I got so many of them, I don't remember them by heart. But we're going to put it on Zemyaza Healing Core if you missed any of this feed. But like I was saying, I feel two gay individuals on Tamar's team instigated this whole situation and took a beautiful opportunity of bringing two independents together and made it ugly. And now people are talking about the fight. But is this really bad publicity? Seriously. Because what's the old saying? Any publicity is good publicity. So all the people who didn't know about Tamar's tour now knows about it. And all the people who are following Chrisean, because I believe she's on a tour herself moving around, but her circuit is much smaller. I feel like the entertainment biz, the only way they want to promote African-American artists is by starting up some drama-entailed bullshit so people can talk about it, okay? I feel, again, this is a huge misunderstanding, and it was accentuated and ignited by two gay individuals who work for Tamar. Because like Chrisean said, she was invited by Tamar. My question is, who allowed Tamar to come on the stage at the wrong time? And if that crown was for Tamar, who on Tamar's team allowed Chrisean to take the crown and put it on her head, if the crown was so-called for Tamar and revealing this so-called birthday cake they wanted to give to her. Okay, you guys? Message to the collective. You're going to have, remember, everything is a ritual. Every situation you see on social media is a ritual. It's called spells. So when you're talking to people, you're creating your atmosphere. But the question is, how are you comprehending the spells that are being spoken? Because one man's dirty bitch is another man's dirty bitch of good wealth. It's all about perspective, and it's all about how you overstand the meaning of these words that are spells. Yeah, Tamar told her to come to the party, to come to the event, but she didn't tell her if she was going to be singing or any of that. And because of miscommunication between both of the entertainers' inner circle, a big fiasco happened because it wasn't clarified the meaning of the invitation. So I have a message to the collective, and I'm going to close. Be careful of the people you call your team, the people you call your family, the people you call your inner circle. Because these are the same motherfuckers that will put you in fucked up situation, even if they're on the payroll. I truly believe both of the gay guys that work for Tamar instigated this whole shit. And it's because of them that they took a very positive opportunity of promotion and turning it into something ugly. Because to be honest with you, I don't think Chrisean would have hit somebody unless she felt threatened to a certain degree. So my question is, with the guy with the gay guy with the glasses, what did you say to Tamar? I mean, what did you say to Chrisean to the point where this very innocent woman who's very much artistic got so angry that she knocked you the fuck out? Because I got the same temper, for real, for real. I'm the nicest person you ever meet. But you take me into the dark side of my energy, you will see how dark and dirty it gets. My question is, what did the gay guy say to her to make her so upset that she knocked him out? I feel Chrisean doesn't like when her dark side come out, because I don't like when my dark side come out. But people are quick to play on us artistic high priestess, especially us dark arts high priestess. And because you see our love and light, you think it can't get ugly real fast and real quick. I'm here to tell you, the most nicest and special ass motherfuckers are the most darkest. And if you want to take it there, we can easily take it there and show you how dark it gets. But I truly feel Chrisean had a reason for knocking that fool out. And he learned real quick that even special motherfuckers got hands. I'm just saying. If you missed any part of this live talk, feel free to hit us up on YouTube at Zemyaza Healing Core. We are going to upload this live to our YouTube so you can catch these gems and place them in your third eye. Watch your circles, guys, because the people that love you, the blood family that's around you, the friends that be with you are the same mother, the lovers that you love on. Shout out to the narcissistic male who's in a subconscious relationship with his mother, Blueface. Hey, hey, narcissistic mom, Carlisa, you raised a good demonic one. They're out there. On some more real shit, the lovers, the family members, these are the same people who will put you in messed up situations and bring you down every time. That's why this ascension is about standing on your own. Because it's those same motherfuckers who you call family, who you call friends, who you call lovers, who you call the same motherfuckers who you call family, who you call friends, who you call lovers, who you call associates that will bring you down every time. And there are connections that don't even know that they're bringing you down, but they are bringing you down. You know, like those girlfriends who are the good hairstylist girlfriends, but their family can't stand you and they stay bringing down your situation and your come up because they don't want you with their daughter. But hey, I'm just a third generational witch talking with ghosts. And to some people, I'm just a bitch who's lost her mind. And that too is okay. So to my shadow collective, watch the company you keep. Because that same fucking company could be the same reason why you're at the same motherfucking spot you were at 3 fucking years ago. I'm just saying. When I found out how old Chrisean was, I realized she's just a young girl in a big game of entertainment. And to stay alive in that game is a hard thing. But Chrisean, like me, is a high priestess for real. And she herself have deities watching over her that she may not even know about right now. But trust and believe, none of them is gonna allow Blueface, her so-called clique, Zeus, and Carlisa to bring her down. Because karmic motherfuckers like that get burnt up every time fucking with high priestesses like us. Shout out to Chrisean and to all the dark goddesses in the world. Thank you, Malka. Thank you, Mildred. Thank you, Nas, for coming through. We appreciate all of you. Again, for all of you guys who don't know, my name is Zazazo, and I'm a third generational Haitian bloodline witch in my Haitian family. And we just finished breaking down the dark side of this fucked up situation of Tamar and Chrisean. I feel that the gay promoters invited Chrisean on a fake ass, let's use Chrisean's clout to promote Tamar. But when she got into the room, they couldn't handle it and they made it go left. But in all actuality, Chrisean is still winning on some old real shit. And Chrisean also helped Tamar's fucking tour be promoted. Because I'll say it again. Did anybody else know that Tamar had a tour going? On some old real shit. I'm gonna be honest. I believe both of the gay guys that had an issue with Chrisean accentuated this whole shit. Because why? The government is trying to promote this gay and lesbian against gay guys. And to be honest with you, they're using the gay men as an agenda to fight against not just black women, but all women. But that's another video for another time. Shame on you, gay guy promoter. Shame on you, gay guy who got knocked the fuck out. Because I know you must have said something to her to make her upset. Whether she was half drunk or whole drunk, what did you say to Chrisean to get her so angry that she felt disrespected? I guess to the point where you thought she wouldn't knock you the fuck out. And she did. On some old real. Can we stop playing into these paradigms of allowing the gay men to be the bad guys? They're playing into it so much so that they're promoting the gay men to work out their agenda of setting this anger frequency ablaze of dysfunction. They did it with T.S. Madison. They did it with the woman who said, the woman who was talking, I don't remember it, but the woman who was talking about calling real black women cis and causing black women to be upset because gay transgender women wanted to call us cis, which I agree, we are not your cis, We are women who have babies. Even if they create a way for you transgender women or for you gay men to have babies, you still cannot. This is why black woman is God. This is why black woman is God. And you will never be able to compare a gay man to a black woman. But because the government wants to perpetrate a division between the black woman, the gay woman, the transgender woman, the LGBTQ, they will do what they can to do that. And they will use entertainers to do it. So you guys, learn from this shadow message. Learn that they will use every gender, every social connection as a way to keep us separated. Make your decisions better and allow yourself to not play into this bullshit. I feel like the gay guys on Tamar's team set up this whole fucking situation or played themselves into this situation and allowed a perfect opportunity of upliftment and turned it into something ugly. I still would like to know, what did the gay guy say to Chrisean to the point where she felt threatened, to the point where she laid them hands on that mother? For real, for real. Again, you guys, thank you for listening. For all of you guys who don't know, hi, my name is Vorja Zazazo, and I'm a third generational healer and master alchemist in my bloodline family. And I finally got my credentials back on going live. So I'm a nobody, and I'm just a nobody trying to give the message to a somebody. So if you were in this live, thanks for listening and thanks for watching. And if you missed any part of this Tales of the Dark Side of the Entertainment Biz, feel free to check us out on Zemyaza Healing Core on YouTube, and you can catch the whole live feed there. Thank you for listening. Thank you, Dollface. Thank you, Easy. Thank you, James. Thank you, Victory. Thanks for everyone for coming through, and we will see you in the next video. I think we're going to talk about Kiki tomorrow. Blissed and fire, you guys. Thanks for listening, and thanks for watching. And remember, if you become a subscriber on my page, I am a tarot card and divinator reader. All of my subscribers will automatically receive free readings with their subscription on this page. Meaning I will have subscriber-only lives where I'm focused on only my subscriber and I'm giving private readings to all of my subscribers. My monthly subscribers also get daily free reads and shout outs when they come into my life. So think about subscribing and becoming a part of the Zoe Warrior families. In the meantime, in the between time, I gotta build this algorithm because they blocked my last channel. So this channel is brand new. So I gotta start all over again. So don't forget to put on your notifications for the next video in the future. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. And again, if you missed any part of this video, feel free to check out the full upload on our YouTube channel at Zemyaza Healing Core, LLC. That's Zemyaza Healing Core, LLC. We're back! And better than ever, bitches. Blissed in fire. Later, gators. Oh, yeah.